is a big spectrum. It can come to any girl, any woman of any age, as long as they are menstruating. So the, like I always tell everybody, that stress is the precipitating event. It is like a volcano waiting to erupt. So you have you either put on weight or any stress or anything which is different happening in your body, it can be precipitated. So lean PCOS are usually very rare. Nowadays in India, we see more of obese PCOS. So lean PCOS, the girls are thin, everything else looks fine, but abnormal hair can come and then acne can come and the periods can become irregular. So when these things happen, they respond well to laparoscopy than to medication. So insulin sensitizers work well with obese PCOS, but they do not work well when it comes to thin lean PCOS. So in these ladies, the dietary changes also is not going to help much. So it is a medical intervention which takes care of these things. So exercise is very important for all the lean and the lean PCOS. And if there is an increased testosterone in their body, that is a free testosterone, then we give something to decrease the testosterone content, which will take care of this acne and the abnormal hair growth which happens. And we also give the hormonal supplements or take care of the hormonal treatment so that the periods can come under control. So as with any PCOS, we only talk about keeping the hormones under control. But like I said, if the stress is the main thing, what is very important in this case of lean PCOS? It is a de-stressing. It can be music, it can be meditation, but de-stressing is the first to stay when it comes to lean PCOS. And when it comes to pregnancy, which is the main issue, that's when we do a laparoscopy and do some ovarian drilling, where we put 4 to 5 holes in the ovary so that the layer on outside the ovary can become thin and the hormones can come back to normal. In PCOS, what exactly is happening is that there is a disharmony. There is increased estrogen and there is decreased progesterone. How do we say that? There is no ovulation. So there will be lots of months of anovulation phase where because of the threshold level of estrogen increases, that's when there is a breakthrough bleeding. So when we talk about it, the culprit in the whole thing is the increased estrogen. So this increased estrogen can lead to metabolic syndrome, can lead to hormonal imbalances, can lead to increased bleeding whenever the periods come, or even the cancerous stages which comes with PCOS. So where is the estrogen which is more? So how do this estrogen can come under control? So when we talk about soya estrogen, where is it coming from? Soya milk. So this is something which we have to keep under control. And even some adulterated milk and adulterated chicken and the dairy things which we talk about has increased in content of estrogen in it. So definitely decreasing these dairy products and the soya products will go a long way along with the exercises in taking controlling the PCOS.